Report. I think it's a fascinating piece of journalism. It's been put together by my colleague Carol Costello. Here it is.
Experts say Anwar al-Awlaki is a low-key extremist. They say fiery rhetoric is out. Understated is in. Listen to one of al-Awlaki's YouTube lectures.
We sometimes neglect our duties toward our fellow Muslims until we fall into their trials and realize the importance of standing in support of the oppressed.
That's right. Understated terrorist talk on YouTube and Facebook. Al-Awlaki has more than 5,000 friends. Jared Brockman wrote Global Jihadism. He's also a U.S. government consultant on counterterrorism.
A lot of guys in the United States read Al-Awlaki's work. They watch his videos. They listen to his sermons.
It's easy.
They are the role models.
Al-Awlaki speaks perfect English. He's American-born. Before leaving the U.S. in 2002, he was an imam at mosques in Colorado, California, and then Virginia, where he had contact with two of the 9/11 hijackers.
Allah.
Imam Johari Abdul Malik knew al-Awlaki. At first, he was moderate in his views and popular.
Young, handsome, Californian, has the benefit of English without an accent.
Then 9/11 happened. Imam Johari told us al-Awlaki grew angry at the way Muslim Americans were treated by authorities. He left for Yemen in 2002, telling his friends,
"This is not an environment for teaching Islam or preaching Islam. I'd rather go back to Yemen." And he told us, I can go back and teach, or maybe I can do a television program.
But in Yemen, he was jailed. Imam Johari says it was after that that al-Awlaki became radicalized with a growing following, his views unrecognizable to those who knew him in the United States.
What he is saying from wherever he is in Yemen to his minions, that it is not only legitimate to kill Americans, that's the message that most people got, but that it is also permissible to kill American Muslims.
Something Imam Johari says is against both Islam and the United States. It may be, he says, al-Awlaki has lost his mind.
Al-Awlaki had written on his website that Major Hassan, the alleged Fort Hood shooter, was a hero. Today, that website is not accessible. It's not clear why, although some experts say al-Awlaki is afraid he's getting too much attention and shut his own website down. Carol Costello, CNN, Washington.